first time out turkey hunting. It's a bucket list species for me. I want to kill a turkey for a long time. I'm finally getting the opportunity here with Nate Anderson and Dane Sly, so I'm pretty excited. Stay tuned.
Some couples straight behind us. He's a bit close in the distance, so hopefully we can get him to come up and play in the decoys here. Put on a show for Michael, then we'll go fishing. Four different toms. It's my best guess. And they're in the bottom below us. It's pretty windy and it's overcast. It was supposed to be sunny, so we set up high. And after about 7:15, they kind of shut up. Then we heard another gobble, probably. I'd say it's probably at least 200 yards away. Then we heard another one about 400 yards away or better. And since then, it's just been really quiet, but we're gonna stay after it. I still think there's a really good chance that we might see one in this spot. Might give another hour and start running and gunning. It's a little chilly, so I need to move. But yeah, let's go with Michael here.
It's a little chilly.
We even bought like special killing hats for this trip. I already lost mine, it's fucking cold. But we are in a good spot to say the least. We're not exactly where we wanted to be, but where we wanted to be was pretty marshy. So we came to the other side of it, which is dry, but it's on high ground. But I really think we need to drop down to the bottom. So I think what we're gonna do is give another hour in the spot or so. Pack up, run the blind and shit to the truck, and grab the tail fan and do some scoot and shoot and shit. So
we're on our 6 second spot for the day. Nice little clearing here in the field. We got Dane laying in the bushes behind the blind. I like this spot. I think it'll work out.
Moved down to a couple cornfields out of the timber. We were hearing about 3-4 different gobblers, and they were kind of down low. So we got the decoys in where they're highly visible. And hopefully we can call them out of the timber here. If they come out, there's no way they're not going to see our decoys if they're looking our direction. So maybe we can get on one.
Just a few short hours later, we get up and decide to run and gun. Little do we know, on this new piece of property, there were a lot of turkeys. This became the focal point of the rest of our season.
Hey, Mike, get the gun up and get ready. Yeah, the front.
Actually back up and I'm afraid.
Just wait. Just don't move. Strickland's a Jake.
I don't think he gives a shit.
Backwoods ahead. Jakes. Mike, you can see them, they're Jakes. Front three.
Are there any guns out there?
No.
do you get them off?
Well, one flat tire later and a relocate done. And we're back at it. We're back where Dane and I were last weekend. And we saw two go on roost. Hopefully we have the same luck tonight. That way tomorrow morning we have them, or else we shoot one tonight. This has kind of been my honey hole for deer and turkey and anything else I like to shoot. So hopefully it stays that way.
We went the rest of the night without seeing any turkey.
This morning we got on about a dozen gobblers. We have not sighted them yet. We think they're down to the bottom right now. And seen some deer, some geese, and another hunter that went to the south of us about 600-700 yards. But it's, overall it's been a pretty good morning so far. We're hoping that after they get out of the bottoms, they come up here. So it's about 7:30 now. Hoping they work our way soon. We saw about 6 jakes in the spot yesterday, but we knew there were long beards in here because there was too much turkey sign. So we're set up in about the only green space that's out here. Hopefully we can get one to come in.
Rain falls on the ground, rest your head in another new town. Is this the place you finally call home? Another job.